Hello everyone, it's time for another phonics lesson. And as always, we're going to start with a revisit and review before we start our main lesson. So today's little warm-up is going to be reading the alternative G grapheme sounds that we did in the previous session. Remember, we're looking for a G or a J. Okay, so read the sentence out loud and see how you get on. Well done. So the sentence reads, I don't have the energy to go to the gym. Sounds about right for me. But well done, everybody. Can you hear the J in energy and gym? And with go, it is a G. All right. So now we're going to move on to something else. And now we're going to look at some tricky words, some high frequency words. Again, these are words that sometimes are difficult to spell using phonics, but we need to know how to spell them. And the first word we are going to look at today is again, again, again. And then we're going to go to different, different. Right. Now let's get on to the main learning for today's phonics lesson, which is alternative pronunciations of the U grapheme. So we'll go over this again in a minute, but you should know that the U grapheme makes the U sound. We're going to look at two other sounds that we can use with this grapheme. Okay, we're going to do it in different ways. Are you ready? Let's get started. Okay, so here is our U grapheme and the pictures on the screen at the moment. All use the U grapheme as the sound. So we have an umbrella. We've got a picture of something that is underground. And we've also got a submarine, submarine, a submarine. So that sound is generally at the beginning. And another sound that the U grapheme can make in some words is like an sound. So for example, we've got a push chair, a push chair. We've also got a lovely Christmas pudding, pudding, pudding. And finally, there's a picture of someone who is going to put something on a table. So put, put. Okay, so that one isn't usually found at the front of a word, at the beginning of a word. It's normally found in the middle or between other letters. And the final way of using the U grapheme that we're going to look at today is using it as a U sound. Okay, so at the top we have got some music, music. We've also got some humans at the bottom of our screen. And my favourite, we have got a unicorn. And again, this version of the U grapheme is generally in the middle. It is now activity time, and I think you're going to get bored of me saying it like that. I'll have to change it up soon. But our activity today, again, we are sorting words into groups, but not just two groups today. We are sorting them into three groups. We've got the U grapheme as an sound. We've got the U grapheme as our short sound, and the U grapheme as our U sound. So once again, have a look at the words, put on right on paper, put them in the right groups, and then challenge yourself by using these words in sentences. And use all the other challenges that I've challenged you with so far, with conjunctions, adjectives, and time adverbials. Well done, everybody. That's us at the end of yet another phonics lesson. Well done. I cannot wait to see the work that you're going to do with this. Have fun with it, and until next time, see you later.